Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are visiting for the first time, thank you so much for checking it out. If you are returning, thank you as well. Today, I'm walking you through how you can design these name posters using Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at express.adobe.com, and I'll go ahead and click on the plus sign, and I'm going to choose a custom size graphic. Now, for this one, I can go to the print size, and I'll choose either letter or poster. That just ensures that it's a great size for printing. If eventually you want to do it, like I said, on a t-shirt, this would be great. I'll go ahead and choose the letter size, and then I'll go to custom just to show you here. Now it's at 8.5 by 11, but I'm going to bump this up to, let's say, 15, and then automatically this will adjust to match because the chain link is turned on. So that's just a little tip there. If you turn the chain link off, you could actually customize and it won't keep it in proportion. So know that the next time you create a custom size graphic. Let's go ahead and click on next, and let's get started with creating our name poster. Let me go ahead and close this up. I'll name this name poster just so I can easily find it when I'm creating a project. I'll choose text, and let's go ahead and add my name here. We'll go ahead and type this out. And right now, I'm going to actually keep that color. Let's select. And for now, I'm going to see what other colors I have in my own color palettes. I do actually like that. I think I may keep that. But now what I'm going to do is select a different font. And one that I like for this project is called Supper Bold. You can actually find more fonts. I have another video that you can check out if you're interested in adding fonts to your Adobe Express account. I'll click on the bold option here, and I just like the way that A looks like right there. Let me make this a little bit larger so you can see. And I'm gonna move this up here, center it on my page. And the next thing I'll do is I'm going to select a secondary style or a highlight style, and that's going to be a secondary color. And I'm going to choose this reddish color. And then what I'll do is I'll come here and unselect certain letters and with their color. I'm going to keep my first letter with this red, because as you saw in the posters ahead of time, we're going to add one letter as we go diagonally. So I have this set up. Let me go ahead and click out here. The next step, basically what I'll do is repeat, or I should say duplicate this as many times as there are letters in my name. So I think I've got, let's see, 7 now. So let's go ahead and grab one and move it down. The nice thing is you can align it using those marching ant signs there, or I should say marching ant lines, and get it as close as you can. Let's see here, we've got 1, 2, 3. That's close enough right there. I'm a little eyeballing it. 1, 2, 3, let's move this down just a tad bit, or let's use our arrow keys for that. Let's move this up a bit, maybe adjust it down. So you kind of get the idea. You will have to do this depending on how many letters are in your name. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I need one more. Let's go ahead and duplicate that, and we'll bring this down. And perfect. Now what I'll do is select them all and just ensure that they are lined up. We'll go align left, perfect. And I can tell by the spacing, these are pretty close. I'm eyeballing it, but close enough for me for this project. I can fine tune it a little bit later if I want to. Now the next step is to adjust each of the red letters as I go down in line. So I'll choose my next batch of name here, or I should say the next batch of letters. Go over to highlight, and it's already selected. And what I'll do is click on the next letter, which is L in my case, and then I will unselect the C, and it will just go down in each letter and repeat the steps. Now it's letter A, and unselect that. So I'll go down and do that to each of these, adjusting it one letter at a time and unselecting the other one. And we'll be done here in just a second. And here is my completed name poster. As you can see, my name going diagonally across because I chose a different color. Your name may vary depending on how many letters are in your name. So you may have to adjust for your name, the size of the project, also the size of the letter, or I should say text box. This is a great way for everyone to share their name. You can do it in your office. You can do it in your classroom, print them out, put them all over the board. You can also print these out, put them on a t-shirt, or maybe put them on some mugs. Really cool way to create a really neat gift idea for your family and friends. So now it's your turn to create your own name poster using Adobe Express. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.